The second portion is very simple. Watch this. Mary says, now, I've already told him what the problem is. He addresses her by saying, it's not my time. Because he says it's not my time doesn't mean I'm not going to do it. Okay, watch this. Because he says it's not time for it does not equate I'm not going to do it. And most of us have heard God say wait, and we interpret it as a no. See, God tells us not yet, hold on, wait. We hear no, never, leave it alone. He says, Mom, ma'am, this ain't time for me yet. What does that have to do with me? But it still is not said, I'm not going to do it. And so your prayer life seems to be like, I'm asking God over and over for it, and he keeps telling me to wait. But you get so frustrated in the waiting that you take it as a no and stop praying.
Come on, God.
See, some of your dreams have just been delayed, and you have canceled them out yourself because of your lack of faith.
All right. Come on, preach up.
You can't get mad at God because you don't have no patience.
Well, come on, God. Preach.
We always quote the scripture about they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength, and they'll say, we quote that left and right, but we miss the last portion of the scripture, because the text says, Lord, teach me how to wait.
All right. Come on.
Lord, when was the last time you told the Lord, teach me how to wait? Some of the stuff you in now, had you just
wait.
You wouldn't find yourself in. Some of the things that you have gotten yourself into, you had to just wait. Lord, teach me how to wait. He tells her, it's not my time yet, but she then takes that as a, okay, I'll be right here when you do it. But while I'm waiting on you, I'm still going to work. Because the next thing she says is, whatever he says do, you do. If that don't bless you, I put it right here. If they not shouting right now, it's time to go to the long version. I put it right here. It says if they don't shout right there, automatically go to the long version. Because if you only really need two steps, A, take it to Jesus, B, whatever he says do, you can stop right there and have your situation to be fixed. Whatever he says do, you ought to be able to do it. It don't feel good, but it's for your good. It don't look good, but it's still God speaking to you. Whatever he says do. If four or five people would just grab that on the way home, and before you make your next move, take it to Jesus. Whatever he says do. If he told you to preach, but you find yourself on the praise team.
Come on,
hi. I'm kind of doing what you said, God. I'm in there. I'm on stage.
Come on, Rhea. Come on.
No, that's not what he said, do. So when he wants to bless you all the way, what if God started giving you a shortcoming? What if God started treating you like you treat him?
Come on.
You said, God, wake me up, but he put you in a coma. You awake. You just on a machine.
Come on, real.
He kind of did it, right? Yeah. Right? Some of y'all treat God like he's just second hand. I'm going to do it okay. If God gave you the same amount of what you give him in response, just stop right there. Just the things that God has told you to do. If you only gave him just what he gives you, watch this. There are some people in the room right now that God has given you a vision, 5, 10 years ago.
All right.
And he laid out the plan for you and everything. You had worked it out, and he had orchestrated all these things to line up, and you looked at one thing and put it to the side.
Right.
You didn't have the money.
Yeah.
I ain't got the money for that. If God was depending on your money to make your plan work, he would have never given it to you. That who gives you vision shall supply provision. All you have to do is be willing to work it.
Come on, God.
It's amazing to me, all these opportunities for people to go to school, they practically begging you to go to school, and yet you'll sit back and be like, school, I can't do it. I can't afford it.
All right.
The only thing more expensive than a higher education is not having one.
Come on, Rev.
If you don't know by now that the world is not set up for you, and at least let's try to balance the scale by being able to think like they think. Watch this. So when God gives us an opportunity to advance ourselves, we as a people should take advantage of it. But we start looking at our own limitations and then start limiting God. Like he ain't never done that before. Huh? Like, for some reason, this God that is responsible for keeping all of the planets spinning, keeping them the same distance away from each other, but yet equally far enough from the sun, and still keeping the air and oxygen mixture on this planet to operate you. And meanwhile, while doing that, knows exactly how many hairs that come and go from your head, along with everybody else in this room, and still know that if he wanted to put you through school or he wanted to pay off your house, he knows exactly the moment that's going to happen, and you question God. If God put you in charge of one simple task like breathing, you would suffocate. If he put you in charge of one task, your job today, sir, breathe for yourself.
Yeah.
That's it. You would die. Because you or I don't know the mixture of oxygen or nitrogen that goes in our lungs or the ratio that it takes to inflate them and deflate them. And yet you worry about how God going to take care of your life.
Come on.
One encounter. And the Bible says that when Adam was formed out of the dirt, God said, and from that moment on, man began to breathe. And every Adam, every since that day, the right calculation has never flawed. And you're trying to worry about how God gonna take care of myself. Put God in these little bitty square boxes like he just that. Whatever he says, how big, how ridiculous, how overwhelming, how crazy it sounds to you, whatever he says, do. The sports company, the word Nikos, simply means activity and movement and doing. How is it that they know exactly how to respond in life and the church folk miss it?
Well,
you go out and spend hundreds of dollars to support Jordan and Nike, and they've been telling you to just do it forever. And the Bible clearly tells you that whatever he says, do. Just do. I would rather put my faith in Jesus than feel life with ebony. He tell you to just do it, you gon' spend it. Jesus said, just do it. Whatever it is that he said. Just do it. Somebody say, just do it. Just do it. When you leave out of here, just do it. Whatever he says, do it. Just start talking to God. Take it to Jesus and start letting remind yourself of what he said to you. His promises that he said to you. Whatever he said, just do. Simple. What you do when you run out of wine?
Well,
come on, preacher.
What do you do when you run out of wine? Watch this. The last piece is my favorite. Watch this.
Come on.
The last one. First one, take it to Jesus. Son of baby, whatever he says, do you do it. Now watch this. The last piece is going to bless one or two folks, and then I'm going to take my seat. Watch this. The last one is follow the recipe.
Come on.
Simply follow the recipe.